From a substance standpoint, he's been pretty consistent over the last 6 or 9 months in terms of the issues that he wants to run on: restoring the Constitution, repealing Obamacare, returning to a period of economic growth of, 4 or 5% annually. What was different today, in addition to sort of the theater of being the first candidate to run for president in this, fantastic arena setting at Liberty University in front of 10,000 people, what was different was that he talked about his religious background, both for his family and himself personally, with greater detail than I've heard before publicly. He talked about his parents, both their immigrant backgrounds, but also his father going through a tough period before he accepted Christ as his savior. In fact, leaving the family for a short period of time. But look, I think if you're part of the Cruz team, you are very pleased about the way everything went today. It's clear that this is being, planned for a period of weeks. While I think the Liberty University site was probably only finalized in the last 10 days, he's going to build on that today. But with raising money online, he's doing a full hour with Sean Hannity tonight on Fox News. He and his wife Heidi are on the Today Show tomorrow exclusively. He's going to spend the next day and a half in New York City doing media, earned media, to try and maximize the potential of this event.
And very charismatic speech, I think, without question, whether you agree with him on his points and on his stands or not. No question, though, that he has ruffled some feathers, not only in the Democratic Party, but also his own party. He talked about the need for courageous conservatives to demand liberty. Was he trying to shoot a little bit at the establishment of the GOP today?
Probably a little bit. I mean, he doesn't mind at all going after the establishment in the Republican Party. They don't like him. He doesn't like them. He's talked about the so-called mushy middle and about running as moderates and losing as moderates. Look, Cruz says 4 million evangelicals stayed home when Mitt Romney was the nominee. By going to the largest private Christian university in the country, he sent an unmistakable message that he's a social conservative, that he's an evangelical, and he's going to go after those votes aggressively, and that he's running as a courageous conservative. And so I think from his standpoint, he knows what his identity and his brand is. He's going to take that all the way as far as he can, and I think he can potentially be a very strong candidate in Iowa and South Carolina, and that's the path for him. It's to win or finish a strong second in Iowa, win South Carolina, and become the conservative alternative to Jeb Bush or whoever the establishment frontrunner is as the primary goes forward.
Obviously, he is the first domino to fall in this race. Does the second, third, and fourth domino come really quickly now that he has entered into it? And does he have an advantage in any way, shape, or form by being the first man in?
The advantage to being first is you can control your announcement. He had the entire day to himself in terms of the news of today. He had a huge political press corps that traveled from 150 miles from D.C. to Lynchburg to be there. And I don't think we're likely to have another announcement perhaps until April 7th when Rand Paul announces in Louisville. So he may have, to some extent, the field to himself for the next 2 or 2.5 weeks. So I think that is an advantage. It's unusual to announce for a federal office 9 days before the financial quarter ends, the fundraising quarter ends. So he got ahead of these other candidates. He wanted to make clear he's running. He wanted to control the news value for his announcement,
right.
And he's going to, run with it as far as he can for the next couple of weeks. But look, by the end of April or by mid-May, we're going to have 4 or 5 candidates in, with 4 or 5 more probably getting in before the summer begins.
Matt Mikowiak with the Potomac Strategy Group, Republican strategist. We appreciate your time as always, Matt. Thank you.
Thank you.